Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we will talk about how to get started with EPM REST APIs. EPM consultants mostly work with EPM Automate utility to automate tasks like loading the data and metadata, taking backups, invoking business rules, refreshing the database, and many other admin activities. You can now use REST APIs to perform similar tasks and much more. When Oracle announced the release of REST APIs, I was so excited, and I'm still excited about the availability of REST APIs. Many of my friends and colleagues back then were hesitant to use REST APIs, and that was mainly because of the lack of knowledge of a programming language like Java, Python, Groovy, or JavaScript. I mostly code in Python, and I absolutely love it. If you're an EPM consultant and want to explore EPM REST APIs, you can try Python to create programs to use REST APIs. So in this video, I want to show you how to test the REST APIs and how to write a simple code snippet, even if you have no programming knowledge. We will be using Postman to test the REST APIs, and we will have a Windows PowerShell code snippet as well by the end of it. I'm at the Oracle documentation page. Let's navigate to the EPM documentation. On the navigation pane on the left side, click on the planning link, and in the next page, you'll see a link for REST APIs. Let's check out the REST APIs documentation. I have to admit something. I love the documentation. It's awesome, and it's pretty extensive. It gives you a high-level overview of the REST APIs, the different applications that support the REST APIs. There's also a table with a list of REST APIs and applications that support the API, and it'll be a good idea to review this list if you're just getting started. Then there's an interesting reveal about EPM Automate and REST APIs. If you didn't know, EPM Automate is built on top of REST APIs. The documentation also has sample code snippets for Java, Groovy, Curl, and there are a few examples for Postman. Now, you don't have to use Java, Groovy, or Curl. You can use any programming language capable of invoking HTTP requests and handling JSON data. There's also a section for prerequisites, few sample integration scenarios that you can review. Another section of the documentation has details about the different methods that are supported, and those are get, post, put, and delete. There's explanation of what each method does. You have details of error handling, versioning of the API, valid status codes, etc. The versioning section provides details about how to construct the URL endpoint for invoking the REST API and how to pass the API version in that URL. In this video, we are going to focus on two REST APIs. Both of them are GET. One of them is GET Planning API Version. The other one is GET Application Details. Let's start with the GET API Version. On the API page, you can see more details about the API. There are a few examples as well. What we are most interested in is the API endpoint and the media or content type. Let's learn how to construct the REST API URL. Line 4 has the URL format. Assume that service name is planning, tenant name is A123456, service type is PBCS, data center is US2. Now here is how we can construct the REST API URL. Make sure you use the details corresponding to your planning instance. This is an example that I'm showing you, but you can follow the same approach to construct the API URL. When we invoke the REST API, we need to pass the username and password. The username should be a concatenation of identity domain and username. So in this case, it will be A123456.arun. The authentication details should be encrypted and passed while invoking the REST APIs. And we will be using basic authentication for this. For the next step, we have to download Postman. If you already have it downloaded, fine. If you don't have, go to postman.com and download Postman for Windows if you're on Windows. It is also available for Mac and Linux. I have it already installed. So once you have it installed, open Postman and on the home page, click on Create a Request. By default, the request method is GET. You can change it to other methods if you want to. Next to the method is where you specify the API URL. Below the API URL, you'll see various tabs. We will be focusing mainly on the authentication and headers tabs. In the authentication tab, you select the authentication method and pass the username and password. Like I said earlier, we will be using basic authentication. In the headers tab, we set the content type as application/JSON. You can find this detail from the API details page. You just have to check for supported media type. Let's copy and paste the URL that we have constructed. Add a / at the end. Set authentication method, provide the username and password. In the headers tab, set the content type. Once again, this is a fictitious URL. I'll be changing the domain name in the URL and giving the actual username and password in the authentication tab. Once you've done the same, it's time to test the API. Let's go ahead and click the send button. You will see the response status as 200 OK, which means it was a success. The response is in JSON format. You can see three keys in the JSON response: is latest, version, and lifecycle. For V1 and V2, you will see that the is latest is false and lifecycle is set to deprecated. So these two are not the latest versions. For V3, you will see that is latest is set to true and lifecycle is set to active. So V3 is the latest API version. One of the cool things about using Postman is you can download the code snippet to invoke the API. So click on the code link and you will see the option to select the programming language on the left. You have options for Java, JavaScript, Python, and many more. What you see here is the code in Windows PowerShell scripting language. Let's copy and paste this into PowerShell and then press Enter. You will see the JSON response. Even without knowing the scripting language, you are able to have a code snippet to invoke the REST API, and that is powerful, one of the best things about Postman. Now let's look at the GET application details API. In here, you have to pass the API version. Good thing we found that the latest version is V3. Add the following to the endpoint URL: /V3/applications/. Make sure authentication details are correct. Content type is set correctly in the headers tab and the method is GET. Let's click send. You'll see the status is 200 OK, which means the API call was a success. The JSON response with the application details is also displayed. Just like the last time, you can copy and paste the code into PowerShell and see how it works. Alrighty, in this tutorial, we saw how to invoke two REST APIs. You can try the Postman examples provided by Oracle in the documentation to get more comfortable with using Postman. I think that is it for this video. Hope you find this helpful. If you have questions or suggestions, let me know in the comment section. In the next video, I'll show you how to invoke these same APIs using Python. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up, and if you love the content that I'm creating, consider subscribing. I'll talk to you all in the next one. Stay safe, stay healthy, take care.